Imagine waking up one day and realizing that everything you see, every sound you hear, every texture you feel is not a direct experience of the world, but a hallucination. Not the kind of hallucination brought on by fever or drugs, but a structured, controlled hallucination that your brain has learned to generate so you can navigate the world. This is not just an abstract theory. It is one of the most groundbreaking ideas in neuroscience today. Reality, as you perceive it, is not directly experienced, but actively constructed. Inside your skull, your brain sits in absolute darkness. It has never seen light, never heard a sound, never felt a thing. It is locked away, sealed off from the external world. Yet somehow it gives you the experience of seeing colors, hearing voices, and moving through space. The question is, how? How does your brain take raw electrical signals from your senses and transform them into the rich, vivid reality you experience? The answer lies in prediction. Your brain is not a passive receiver of information. It is an active generator of experience. It doesn't simply wait for sensory data to arrive. Instead, it constantly predicts what it expects to be there and then compares those predictions with incoming signals. When the prediction matches reality, everything feels stable. But when the prediction is wrong, you experience surprise, confusion, or even illusion. Your experience of the world is not a perfect reflection of what is actually out there. It is a hallucination that your brain controls, using sensory information to keep it in check. Take something as simple as watching a ventriloquist. Logically, you know that the voice is coming from the performer, but your brain binds the sound to the puppet's moving mouth because that explanation makes the most sense based on the patterns it has learned. Your brain is always filling in the gaps, constructing a best guess of what's happening. Think about color. The blue sky, the green of trees, the red of an apple. These colors don't exist out in the world in the way you think they do. Light waves themselves have no color. They are just different frequencies of electromagnetic energy. It's only when those waves hit your eyes and your brain processes them that you perceive color. Your brain creates the colors, adjusting for shadows, lighting, and context to make sense of what's in front of you. That's why two people can look at the same object and see different shades, why illusions can trick your mind into seeing colors that aren't actually there. Your brain doesn't just guess at color, it guesses at everything. In a noisy room, when someone speaks, you don't hear each word separately. Your brain predicts what they're going to say next and fills in missing sounds. When you glimpse a shadow in the dark, your brain might make you think it's a person, an animal, or something lurking in the corner, only to correct itself when you take a closer look. Even your experience of time is a construction. You don't perceive the world in real time. Your brain processes visual and auditory information at different speeds and has to synchronize them, giving you the illusion of a smooth, continuous now. This process follows a mathematical principle called Bayesian inference. Your brain is like a scientist, constantly forming hypotheses and updating them based on evidence. If you wake up and see that the ground is wet, your brain must decide, did it rain overnight or did someone turn on the sprinklers? If you live in a desert, rain is unlikely. So your brain leans toward the sprinkler explanation. If you live in a rainy city, you assume it was the weather. The same process happens every second of your life. Your brain weighs past experiences against new data and decides what is most likely to be true. Most of the time, your predictions work seamlessly. But when they fail, illusions and hallucinations emerge. This is why optical illusions can convince your brain that two identical shades of grey are different colours. Your mind insists on its predictions, even when the raw data contradicts them. In dreams, the prediction system runs unchecked. With no sensory input to constrain it, your brain generates entire worlds from scratch. It constructs landscapes, invents people, and even creates conversations where the other person's words surprise you, as if they have independent minds of their own. Psychedelic drugs disrupt the predictive process, allowing the brain to relax its assumptions. Instead of filtering out unlikely patterns, It lets them in, creating unusual connections between senses. People report seeing sounds, feeling colors, and experiencing time as fluid rather than linear. If your perception of the external world is a controlled hallucination, then what about your perception of yourself? Neuroscience suggests that your sense of self, your feeling of being an individual with a body, a name, and a personality, is also a construction. Your brain generates a continuous sense of identity to keep you functioning. But this sense of self is just another prediction, another hallucination shaped by past experiences. Experiments show that the brain can be tricked into altering its sense of self. In the famous rubber hand illusion, a person places their hand out of sight while looking at a fake rubber hand being stroked with a brush. After a short time, the brain adopts the rubber hand as part of the body, even reacting with fear when the fake hand is threatened. Virtual reality experiments have shown similar effects. When placed in a digital body, people start to feel as if the avatar is truly them, even if it looks nothing like them. Your brain doesn't just hallucinate the world, it hallucinates you. In rare neurological conditions, people can lose their sense of ownership over a limb, insisting that their hand no longer belongs to them. Others experience out-of-body sensations, feeling as if they are floating above themselves. Some people with Cotard's syndrome believe they're already dead. These are extreme cases, but they reveal a deeper truth. Your sense of self is not fixed, but flexible, a shifting prediction shaped by the same processes that create your perception of the world. So what does all of this mean? It means that reality, as we perceive it, is not fixed. It is not something we passively receive. It is something we actively construct. The world you experience is a model, a controlled hallucination your brain generates to help you survive. Most of the time, that model aligns well with the real world, but sometimes it glitches. The next time you see something unexpected, feel an emotion rise from nowhere, or experience a sense of déjà vu, ask yourself, is this reality or is this just my brain making its best guess? Because in the end, the world you see is the world your brain predicts, and that is both humbling and extraordinary. Now that we understand how our brain constructs reality, we can harness this knowledge for personal growth and awareness. By becoming more aware of our brain's predictive nature, we can start to question our perceptions and challenge our assumptions. This awareness allows us to be more adaptable, more empathetic, and more open to new experiences. It can help us to break free from limiting beliefs and see the world with fresh eyes. So the next time you encounter a situation that seems puzzling or feel an emotion that catches you off guard, remember, your brain is doing its best to make sense of the world. Embrace the uncertainty and use it as an opportunity to expand your understanding of yourself and the world around you. Please like and subscribe to our channel for more fascinating content on science and history.